Hi, this is Shiva Rajaya from vitalcoaching.com, and we are talking about vital sex and tantric sex. By the way, I'm kind of, you know, shifting between those two terms. They are pretty much equivalent, so don't make too much out of it, whether I'm using vital sex or tantric sex. The next video that I'm going to talk about now, this topic for this video, is how to sexually please a man. You know, this is a question that is coming from lots of my female friends, including lovers as well. It's something that women are, you know, want to know about. If you are in a straight relationship, if you are in a gay relationship, of course, you can apply exactly the same kind of ideas. And I'm going to give you some hints about what is going on in a man's body and what I feel sometimes are the core mistakes that women are making with trying to be to please a man sexually, and also what you can add to your sex play to make it more juicy and more interesting for your lover. So the first point is slow down. This is probably the number one mistake that I see women making when it comes to sex. It's like this form of conditioning that a man needs to be overstimulated physically for him to have pleasure. This is not true at all. Very often the touch that is going to give a man the most pleasure is going to be a very soft touch. Sometimes no movement at all. You can put your hand on a man's penis and just keep it there with some oils, hardly moving it, and turn that for him into this incredible pleasure trance. You know, the fact that it has to be a very fast movement, this is like some porn conditioning or some traditional society conditioning, is not true at all. Whether you are giving your partner oral sex, or whether it's hand stimulation, or if it's through intercourse, slowing down, establishing connection is probably the number one thing that you can start applying in your life right now. So slow down. The second thing that I just mentioned is connection. You know, as a man, what you want to feel is that your lover is there and is really present. It works, of course, the other way around as well. You know, women are complaining about men being a little bit lost and distracted during sex as well. But right now we are focusing really on that polarity. So if you are a woman and you want to give a man pleasure, the first thing needs to be really an energetic connection. It means that he must feel that you are present, that you are there, totally present with him at this very moment. So how do you do that? The first thing is that you turn off your cell phone, you leave all the distractions out of the room, you prepare the space as well, you know, put some candles or some incense around. And it's of course something that you can co-create together. But the point is really this, it is that you are present, you are not being distracted, you're not thinking about all sorts of other things. So having the time and the space to really relax into this sexual temple that you're creating together, then this is something that is going to enhance the man's pleasure. The other point that is very important is that you can really check in, you know, like wanting the man to micromanage you through a practice, that's not necessarily the way to go. But having eye contact and checking with him, are you enjoying this? Does that feel good? You know, every now and then, it doesn't mean that you are asking questions all the time. It's just a few core moments to check in that what you're doing is actually in alignment with what gives him pleasure. So that's another aspect which is very important, check in. The fourth aspect is that this is not about applying a given recipe. It's not mechanical. It's not about taking a set of ingredients, putting them together and just hoping that it's going to work. No. Sex is an art form. An art form means that you have to put your feelings and your heart and your intention into it. You have to dare to experiment. You have to accept the fact that sometimes you're going to do something that is the wrong note, that doesn't feel right. But if you're afraid of making mistakes, then you don't play the music very well either. So, you know, going with the flow and trusting your instinct. And if you feel like doing something or going in a certain direction, you can tell your partner, you can say, I'm going to try something that might feel a little bit challenging. Are you okay for me experimenting a little bit with that? Because I want to really know what's going to happen when I do that. You know, for instance, there are certain techniques which have to do with pressure points, right? So those are called the armoring techniques. And you can, for instance, start pressing on the body very hard with your thumbs on very specific pressure points, that in ways that might feel uncomfortable. But the thing is that the moment you release, it's going to give you lots of bliss, lots of juice, lots of energy is being released through those the armoring techniques. So, for instance, that when you start with this technique, you might feel a little bit uncomfortable. You might not know exactly which way to go with this technique, but you try and you experiment, and eventually you become good at it. And it's the same with slowing down or going faster. It's the same with different oral sex techniques, different ways of touching him. It's all about experimenting, trying, and to become a master at it, you need to play, you need to try, you need to experiment, you need to practice. Okay? So I'm going to summarize for you those four points. Those are really mindsets. You notice that I'm not talking about a very specific way of touching. I'm talking about just mindsets, intentions. What are the qualities that you bring into this space? So slow down, connect, check in, trust your instinct. Have fun. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.